Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a slow cooker sirloin roast with vegetables. And I want to show you what I've put out here to work on. I have my potatoes prepared. There were 5 russet potatoes about like this that I peeled and then I chunked up so that they would be about equal sized chunks. It doesn't really matter too much because we're going to cook those in the slow cooker and they definitely will get very tender. So your choice of what size you want. Then I chose carrots, a carrot something like this that I peeled and cut into equally sized chunks. Over here I have some soups that we're going to put in. This is golden mushroom soup. It's an equivalent of 2 cans of golden mushroom soup, 2 10.75 ounce cans. And then I have beef broth, 2 10.75 ounce cans of beef broth. So we're going to be mixing together our 2 kinds of soup along with some packaged onion soup. And that's why I don't have onions as one of my vegetables, because the onion flavor is coming from soup. The first thing I need to do is to drain the potatoes and carrots. And I have a colander over at the sink, so I'm just going to bring these over and let the potatoes go through. Let the water go through, reserving the potatoes, and then the carrots as well. You don't have to keep them separate. You do want to cover them with water while you're trying to get some of your other things together, because they will turn brown if you don't. But here we have our mixture of vegetables, and I'm just going to bring that back and let it sit on the counter. Now we're going to mix up the sauce that goes over all of this. Our sirloin roast is right here. It's 2 pounds. So the amount of sauce that I'm making is the appropriate amount for 2 pounds. If you only have a 1 pound roast, then just divide each ingredient by 2, because a lot of times I'm doing 2 cans or 2 packets or something like that. I'm going to put in my golden mushroom soup in a large bowl. And then to that, I'm going to add my beef broth, the 2 cans, or you may have homemade. Any of these you can replace with homemade soups. People have asked me that before. I do this from cans a lot for convenience. And I think a lot of people like to see something that is convenient and easy to put together and just stick in the crock pot. But I don't necessarily say that that's the best way to do it. It's just, if you have the time to make homemade beef broth, then you can use some of that that you have. It's equivalent to 2 10.75 ounce cans. So you see, this is quite a bit of sauce. Our 2 packets here, just empty in the first one. That's going to give a lot of flavor, and you'll have a lot of onion flavor from these as well. And now I need to stir. Here we have our very flavorful mixture. And what I want to do is make sure that this mixture touches all of the carrots and potatoes and all of the beef roast. So what I'm going to do is bring my vegetables and place them in here. They just kind of go into the soup and then they will go into the slow cooker. Eventually, I'll be pouring the sauce over everything, but we want to pre-soak everything in the sauce, not for long. Just let them go in and then dip them back out. So when I come back, I'll have this stirred around and then I'll have it removed and put in our slow cooker. Here we have our vegetables in the slow cooker, and you can see that they're nice and juicy already. It's just a scant covering, but it helps to go ahead and give each one of those a little bit of the sauce before we continue. You notice I have aluminum foil here. That's never necessary for a crock pot, but in this case I have liquid that's going in, and I want to keep it enclosed around the vegetables and around the roast as much as possible, and that will make everything so tender at the end. I think you'll like it that way, but if you don't want to use the aluminum foil, just omit that. Now we're ready to take our 2 pound sirloin roast and lift it into our sauce, which is barely used. It just was used to cover each one of those pieces of vegetables. And we'll put this in. I have washed this off and patted it dry with paper toweling. And then I want it to be covered in all parts of the outside, of course. And then I will be placing that on top, and then I'll pour the liquid over everything. Now this may be a little bit messy, but I'll go ahead and see if I can do it with this skimmer. May break apart in the middle. I don't think so because it's not cooked, but just lay that out on the top. And as it cooks, the juice from that roast will drip down through the vegetables and help them become even more succulent and juicy. Now the sauce itself, just go from one end to the other and pour it on, let it go down. And hopefully you haven't put a hole in the aluminum foil, and you see how snugly that sauce fits in there around the roast. It couldn't be bad like that. Now I'm just going to bring this in and cover. That allows me to look at it sometimes by unfolding this. And this is quite a lot. It's going to make a hearty meal, but it fits in one of these oval crock pots. If your crock pot is smaller, I would say you're going to have to cut down on the size of meat and the amount of vegetables. And you probably will just need half as much sauce. But I designed this to go with the slow cooker that I had. So I put the lid on, and then I have this set to high already, and let's set this time to 4 hours. I think this should be done in 4 to 6 hours, and I just want to check it at 4 hours. So that's the reason for the timer. I'll be back when it's done. Our slow cooker sirloin roast has been cooking for 4 hours, so let's check in on it. I'm going to take the lid off and set it aside. And then I'm going to examine this to see if it is broken open and spilled out. It doesn't look like it from here, but I'm going to lift this, being careful of the steam that has built up. And you can see that nice juice all the way up to the top. That's because the aluminum foil has stayed in place and protected it. There's no reason that it shouldn't, unless you just happen to hit it the wrong way when you put it in the container and break a hole in it. But this will ensure that those potatoes and those carrots are so moist and tender, and also this sirloin roast will be very tender. So what I plan to do is use some tongs and utensils, whatever I need, to get the roast out and place it on a cutting board. And then I'm just going to let it rest for about 10 minutes, and I will maybe work on the vegetables or something, try to get things together for serving. There we go. It is shrunk, but that's what you expect. A lot of juice came out of that. And there's some potatoes and carrots I see on the bottom. That's fine. I'm just going to get some aluminum foil and drape it over the top, and I'll be back. I let our sirloin roast rest for about 10 minutes under the aluminum foil, and then I got it out and I started slicing it, and then I arranged the vegetables around it. So you can do whatever you want to in terms of serving this. You could chop up the meat, and these are already kind of chopped. You can just put them together in a bowl and put your gravy over it and eat it like stew if you want to, but I prefer to treat it in a more formal manner. So I would take my plate and maybe get a couple of these end pieces. That's a very tiny piece, but these were tender when I sliced them, and the vegetables were tender as well. I got a little bit of potato here and carrot. And I like arranging them on a platter like this. You don't have to do that. You can put your vegetables in one bowl and your meat on a platter if you like to. But there is this thing of the gravy. The juice that came out of that roast and vegetables was about 5 cups. And I decided to taste of it, and I'll take another taste of it right now. I don't want any of the grease that might be on top, and I did use this fat separator and poured off the fat, but there just was so little fat that there really wasn't much that got poured off. I just want a taste of it and verify that it's not too salty. Actually, it has a wonderful flavor. It's very rich and deep. It's salty enough, but not too salty. You might think with all those soups and also the onion soup that is very spicy and salty, that it would be too much. It would overpower everything. But potatoes are a natural element that will take the salt out of things. We did not put any salt in this roast or with these vegetables. So all of the soups that were added provided the salt, and it turns out just perfect for this amount. I decided to pour some of the juices that are left into a little pitcher that can be served at the table. And then I decided to pour some of the juice over the top. Now, I could have made a gravy of this by adding cornstarch or flour, along with maybe a little water, maybe a little milk, but just to thicken it up, it could be done that way. But this is so tasty and makes such a lovely au jus type of gravy, I think I would take advantage of it. So what you can do is just kind of go ahead and put a little over your vegetables and your meat to keep it from drying out. And then when people get their servings, they can get a little of that, but you also have some to serve on the table. This definitely will keep this nice and moist, and it will look nice too. So I'm going to take a bite over here where I have my place setting, and I'm using a steak knife and a fork here, and we'll just go for this little tiny piece. You can see it's very tender. Just pulls apart like that. And a little bit of potato, a little bit of carrot, and these just cooked wonderfully in that foil. You couldn't ask for them to do any better. And I think what I'll do with my bite is give it a little bit of the reserved sauce. So there we go. It's not exactly gravy, but then again, it is kind of an au jus gravy. Here we go. First thing I got was the roast. So good. Those flavors are just wonderful together. It really is good, and I want to tell you, it's such an easy way to make a fairly dramatic looking meal, and it's really a tasty meal. It's not just for show. It's like down home cooking good. It's really tasty. I hope you enjoy it.